This is Dr. Matt Fry with the New York State Integrated Pest Management Program at Cornell University. In this module, we're going to identify the four common signs of a rodent infestation and how to interpret them.
Rodents are nocturnal animals, with peak levels of activity just after sundown and just before sunrise. They have relatively poor vision, and therefore rely on other senses and signals to navigate within their environment. Fortunately, we are able to see some of these signs, and can use them to identify which rodent pest we have, determine their activity patterns, and estimate their population size. The first sign of a rodent infestation is poop. Rodent droppings are nasty, but they're also quite informative. First, the size and shape of droppings can help you determine which species of rodent is present in your home or office. Pictorial keys are available from the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, or the CDC, and help to differentiate between several types of droppings. For example, droppings with blunt ends that are larger than 1/3 of an inch belong to adult Norway rats, whereas smooth droppings, about 1/4 of an inch in length, with at least one pointed end, are from the house mouse. Droppings left by other pest species can sometimes be confused with rodent poop. For instance, cockroach droppings are about the same size and shape as mouse poop. However, striations that are present on the droppings of cockroaches are used to differentiate the two. In rodent control programs, the bait that is used can often change the color of rodent droppings. In this case, green droppings indicate that the bait has been consumed, and chances are this rodent is already dead. In addition to pest identification, droppings tell us where rodents have been and are considered by some experts to be the roadmap of rodent activity. As rodents navigate from their nest to food source, they defecate, or poop, also leaving tiny droplets of urine and a second sign called grease marks. Together, these cues tell other rodents where to find food or shelter, with commonly used trails having more droppings and thicker grease marks. Following droppings or grease marks can lead you to where rodents have entered the building, where they are nesting, or potential food and water sources. Where these marks are absent, inspections can sometimes reveal the presence of footprints in the dust. As we will see in subsequent modules, trails left by rodents provide an optimal place for rodent control devices. A third sign left by rodent populations are gnaw marks from chewing. Rodents may chew on objects for a number of reasons, but typically do so to obtain actual or perceived resources. It is hypothesized that rodents chew on wires because these mimic twigs, which can provide insect food items or fluids for drinking. In other instances, rodents will make commonly used openings larger for easier access to their nest or food source. Rats in particular can chew through thick plastic of dumpster lids to obtain food sources. This chewing wears down their teeth, which can grow up to 0.4 millimeters per day. Like droppings, gnaw marks can be used to identify your pest. If marks left by a pair of teeth are 1 to 2 millimeters wide, you likely have mice, whereas pairs of teeth that are 3.5 to 4 millimeters wide were probably from rats. In suburban areas or urban parks, rodent burrows constitute a fourth indicator of an infestation. Norway rat burrows have a typical structure, including a main entrance and 1 or 2 bolt or escape holes. Burrow openings that are 1.5 to 3 inches in diameter, with a smooth appearance, are likely to be active. By stuffing burrows with paper or collapsing the opening, you can confirm that a burrow is active by rechecking the next day. An estimate of the rodent population in an area can be obtained using the following formula. This equation takes into account the 3 openings per burrow and the average number of rodents in a family unit. This number, however, is only an estimate, as resource availability and control tactics will change rodent population dynamics.
In this module, we learned about the 4 common signs of a rodent infestation and how this information can be used to determine rodent entry points, nest sites, and food sources. In the next module, we're going to talk about trap selection and placement to enhance rodent control. Please visit our website for additional information on these topics. Thank you.